Over the past year, we've learned much more about the spotted lantern fly. It's an invasive species that has come to our area, especially in southeastern Pennsylvania. And what are some of your thoughts about how we can address the invasive species, the insect? What are some of the ways that the department is working in order to help farmers and also help protect our forests as well, as far as that particular insect goes?
You know, the spotted lanternfly, you know, it's been here since 2014, first time in North America. And we went from one municipality to a county to 3 to 9 to 13 counties, including Montgomery County, that are quarantined. I'll be truthful that, you know, the challenge has been this pest. There's a lot we don't know about it, right? And we've got 25 research projects underway from Pennsylvania to the Mid-Atlantic region to Canada and even other parts of the world, trying to help us solve this problem of how do you contain, suppress, eradicate this pest that, you know, in the last couple of years has shown no decrease in its appetite and no decrease in its destruction. So we're working hard at it. Our goal is to do a couple of things. One, research, and we'll keep working at that to find some broad-based control. Okay. We know we have to keep it inside that quarantine. So to your constituents, you know, I always ask them to please be mindful that we're in the heaviest populated area of Pennsylvania. If you leave the quarantine area, just be aware that, you know, that it's not riding with you. It's an opportunist. And for folks who are traveling in and coming back out, I'd say the same, to make sure we can still continue to do commerce. And the other piece is just around education and outreach and awareness of, you know, the, you know, control on your home property or the forest lands or farms. While we get the research and the science catching up with our need here.
What are some of the things that you would suggest for the people living back in the 53rd District that they can do to try and mitigate this issue? If they see a spotted lantern fly, who do we contact? If they see an egg casing, what are they supposed to do? I've had constituents come up to me throughout when I was door knocking throughout my campaign process, and they mentioned, oh my gosh, we have trees that are fully covered. I've seen tape around the trees trying to attract them and get them stuck on there. I see people running around a parking lot sometimes trying to stomp them as they hop away or fly away. What are some of the things, the recommended practices that the department has asked the residents of Pennsylvania to do?
Yeah, it's a great question. So how do you sort of, even while we're researching and trying to, you know, find a solution, you also have to live, right? And, sure. And maintain some quality of life there. And I know that's difficult in some of those areas that I've been in and the calls that I've taken. Important, we have a list of, you know, commercially available sprays and insecticides that are effective. They're commercial scale, right? It's not going to be, you know, the broad-based spray, but there are, you know, commercially available products that are good for. We have a listing on our website. If you go to the Pennsylvania Department of Agriculture, I won't give you all the W's, but just if you put in the Pennsylvania Department of Agriculture and choose the spotted lanternfly, you'll see some control methods there. But one is spraying and being, you know, you can use that around, you know, the garden and homes and, you know, safely. It's all commercially available. You know, if you see the egg masses, and this is the season to watch, right, is, you know, scrape them, destroy them. There are a couple of methods. You could do it just by, you know, the scraping with a card or a knife or a stone or something just to sort of kill those things, right? Every one of those egg masses is another 30 to 50 flies.
Okay.
So if you get rid of an egg mass, you've taken care of a few. And then if they have any of the Atlantis tree on their property, there is a cut and spray method, because the spotted lanternfly is attracted to the Atlantis tree, which is also an invasive, by the way. And it's usually found any place where there's disturbed land. So if you look around the developments, you'll see them. But again, go to the website, take a look at those control methods, and both for the Atlantis tree and cutting it, but also the spotted lanternfly.